Let's talk about Dual WAN when it comes to UniFi. Dual WAN is exactly what it sounds like. It's using multiple internet connections for load balancing or redundancy in your UniFi network. But what are your options when it comes to configuring Dual WAN deployments? And what are the best practices for taking full advantage of that kind of setup? In this video, Crosstalk's own David Barger is going to talk about everything that you need to know when it comes to setting up Dual WAN in UniFi Network. And remember, Crosstalk Solutions is available for all kinds of network design, setup, and troubleshooting. So be sure to contact us using the links in the description if you want us to ensure that your network is running smoothly, dual WAN or not. Okay, take it away, Dave.
We're going to take a look at configuring multiple WANs, in my case, two of them. It's important to note that UniFi gateways are able to handle up to 8 WANs at once, depending on the model. In a 2-WAN scenario, you designate one ISP as the primary WAN. Under normal operations, all of the internet traffic flows out the singular interface. The secondary interface is only used if that primary interface is marked as down. Now, there are a few ways that you can classify a WAN interface as down, and we'll talk about that in a minute. Those parameters are called SLAs. The important thing to keep in mind is that with basic failover, you're simply switching between primary and secondary WANs, or if you have a lot of LANs, you have basically a list of WANs they can fall through. Once the primary WAN or any of the WANs that are listed higher up in that list are available, it will switch back to those. If we pull up my UniFi console here, you can see that my Gateway Ultra currently has one WAN connected to it. I have a PEP link here with an AT&T SIM that I want to use as a failover, which, by the way, this is one killer dual modem router. If you're interested in learning more about this piece of hardware, make sure you check out our other PEP link videos or reach out to us directly, as we are PEP link gold partners. But let's go back to configuring the router. We actually have to tell it, hey, we want to use a second WAN. So let's use one of your LAN ports as a WAN port. This is called port mapping. We do this by going to Settings, Internet, and here you see I already have the second WAN enabled. If you don't see yours, just click that little Add WAN button. I just have to click on the secondary WAN 2 here and tell it which port I want to use. Let's use port 4 and click Apply Changes. Now, right below here, we can see the two WAN options, failover versus load balancing. But we're only working with failover right now, so we'll plug in our secondary WAN and make sure we select it as backup. This means that my primary WAN is in use and will only ever use that AT&T PEPlink WAN if it's marked down. Now let's talk a little bit more about those SLAs. This is how UniFi actually determines if a WAN is usable or if it's considered down. By default, UniFi is sending ping probes out of each WAN interfaces to ping.ui.com, Cloudflare, and Google. Out of these three, if any of these two fail, the link is considered to be down. To be honest, this is a great default policy, and unless you have a specific use case, you likely don't want to change this, but I'll show you how to do it just in case you do. So let's click Create New SLA. Let's call this SLA Google and Quad 9. You'll see here we have sections called verification servers. This is essentially the first target that we're going to send a ping to. Let's put 8.8.8.8 as our first server IP. We'll also select the ping interval to be 5 seconds, and there'll be a time period of 60 seconds. This is essentially saying every 5 seconds we'll send out a ping to 8.8.8.8, and over the course of 60 seconds we'll take the averages of packet loss and latency and compare it to the defined values here. The defaults are 20% for packet loss and 1,500 milliseconds for latency. And once again, these default values are pretty good. We'll add a second one below here that goes the Quad 9 that has the exact same information on it. Now that we have two verification servers, we can add a couple more smarts to this. Possibly we want the link to be considered down if both targets are failing. Maybe if there's just one. Maybe we have 5 targets and we want to just consider it to be down if 2 are having an issue. There are tons of options here, so pretty much any need you have, you can make it work. Either way, we'll click Add on what we have here, and then we can go back to the WAN page and apply these SLAs to each WAN. And again, for most basic setups, the auto SLA is just fine. Let's talk about load balancing. This is where you configure a weight to each interface. In our dual WAN example here, we may add 50-50 or 50% to each WAN. This means half of the traffic will go out WAN 1 and the other half will go out WAN 2. But for you, maybe one WAN has more capacity than the other, so we could maybe set one to 75% and the other to the 25. Let's go back into our UniFi panel and change our failover here to load balance. Now, this weighted load bounce percentage is not perfect by any means. When a new session hits the router bound for the internet, it will randomly assign that session to a WAN based on the weighted low bounce percentage we define here. With 50-50, it's basically flipping a coin when a new session hits the router and where it's going to send it. Let's say, for example, we're uploading a large YouTube video. Maybe one of our WANs is better suited for this. Your weighted low bounce settings don't really take into account the size of the traffic, just the probability of which WAN it's going to select. Once that YouTube session starts the upload and it goes out a WAN, that entire session is going to stick to that same WAN. This is where things like policy-based routing could help. No matter if you're using standard failover or weighted low bounce, you can make policies that send traffic out specific WANs. Let's go ahead and go through a quick example here. We'll pull back up our UniFi instance here and go to Policy Engine, Policy-Based Routes. We'll click Create Route, and we'll call it YouTube Outbound Policy. We'll then select the WAN that makes the most sense for YouTube uploading, and then down below you'll notice this little kill switch option. This is effectively an option that forces the traffic out the WAN you have defined. For better or for worse, all of the traffic for YouTube in our case is going to go out this WAN, even if that WAN is down. Finally, down below, we'll actually define the YouTube piece of this. We'll say destination YouTube.com, and I'll add in all of the other relevant YouTube domains as well. You should note that it implicitly does add the subdomains of the particular domains that you put in here. Now we have a policy-based route that's going to force all of our YouTube traffic out WAN 1. Again, this works for failover or load balancing. With load balancing, you have a failover inherently built in. So if one of your weighted load balancing WANs goes down, the other will pick up the slack. So if you're on a metered connection, maybe on the secondary WAN, you want to make sure you use policy-based routing to restrict this down. Maybe you want to force your guest network out WAN 1 and only WAN 1, so if it does happen to go down, you're not going to be paying a bill for your guest traffic. One final note, there's one type of multi-WAN system that UniFi does not support. This is called bonding. I find that most people believe that weighted load balancing is the same as bonding, which is not the case. As we discussed, weighted load balance is simply sending traffic out an individual WAN port based on the probability you defined in the weighted load balance percentage settings. So if you do a speed test, you're only going to get the speed of one WAN. With bonding, you can actually use multiple WANs at the same time for a session. Now, not every router can do this. Actually, very few routers can do this. This is another use case for this peplink right here. Peplink has been offering this for years, and it is a really nice feature when you want to bond a lot of non-traditional WANs like cellular and Starlink. Bonding has other features built in, like redundant packet sending, so that if one WAN dies during a critical stream, like a VoIP call or a YouTube live stream, you won't even notice. Overall, that's all you need to know to get started with dual WANs on UniFi. If your business has any network consulting needs, don't hesitate to reach out to us here at Crosstalk Solutions. Thanks for liking and subscribing.